All right, so buying pussy is probably like one of the most ancient purchases of all time. Probably one of the first things ever purchased on this planet was some pussy, if you really think about it. Like, it go back a long way. And a lot of people got a lot of different opinions about paying for pussy. A lot of people feel like, as a man, you paying for it regardless, whether it's a date, whether it's a bottle, whether it's a hotel room, you paying for it. I ain't gonna lie, I completely disagree with that. I'm gonna let y'all know why. And I'm gonna tell y'all some stories. We got some stories to tell about paying for a little pussy too. So we finna get this shit started, man. All right, man. We here. I got my two guests with me. You know what I'm saying? I got Flame and Mary J here. I'm gonna let y'all introduce y'all self. Let everybody know where to find y'all at.
BCE Flame everywhere. Type in BCE Flame everywhere. Flame, nice. Bitch.
Hey. Let me know what you do too, though.
Oh, yeah. I'm an artist. I sing and rap. I'm trying to get into acting now, too. I just did a little short film movie for Netflix. Yeah, I'm trying to, you know, be the Drake of Chicago.
Facts.
What's up, y'all? It's your favorite chocolate baddie, Mary J. I'm radio personality, media personality, PR, all that good shit. Literally, you could Google me, Chocolate Baddie Show, on everything.
Facts. All right, we got to start the show off respectfully, man. You know? But yeah, paying for pussy. What do y'all feel like paying for pussy consists of, man? Like, when they come to paying for pussy, like, a lot of people say, if you buy a date, you buy this, you buy that, you pay for some pussy. Like, do y'all agree with that, though?
I do, in a certain way. You know? Okay. I feel like, you know,
so
you just don't get pussy is not free. Like, that's not nothing that, like, you just women just don't give it to you without you doing anything. Like,
right.
Whether it's time, whether you buying them a little food.
So time consider paying for pussy?
I mean, yeah. You exchange your time. Y'all consider that paying?
Cause some chicks only really want time. She.
Alright, so in that case, do you feel like you sold some pussy before then?
Most definitely.
Okay.
Not in a sense of, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, I'm about to have sex with you. Give me this money. But, like, yeah. Like, nigga.
I would rather it be that way. I would rather it just be.
You'd rather be a direct transaction.
I would rather it be, instead of you playing, instead of I'm taking you out and you out. If you, how much is it? Fuck you, time out.
I'd rather
it
just, point,
how much is it? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like.
But at that point, you might as well just, you know, go get a whore or something, like a prostitute.
Is it paying for pussy in your relationship? Or is y'all consider it paying for pussy like any bitch? Like, I'm finna spend some time with you so I can fuck.
I feel like in a relationship, you definitely not paying for pussy.
Yeah, like you're in a relationship. Now it's an exchange thing. Like,
you might be paying for the head, though.
But I never say.
Hold on.
You might have a point.
In a relationship, you might be paying for the head, though.
If you saying time is considered paying for pussy, you spending time with a bitch for the rest of your life, you with her, right?
For sure.
So you steady paying for that pussy each and every time. You feel what I'm saying?
I disagree.
If you look at it, but technically, if we get down to paying for pussy, actually, you know, spending money on pussy,
I think that's what we going
no,
with.
No, time would not be considered that, but I feel like all pussy should have a price.
Yeah,
let's
but
say that.
And like,
all pussy should have. Everything come with a cost. Everything in life come with a cost.
Just even like,
but a dollar amount, that's a little different.
Yeah, for sure. But I think I just like because even coming into like talking to certain chicks, like certain chicks you get vibes that like she gonna make me damn near work for this pussy. You know
right.
what I'm saying? And some chicks want you to like prove yourself.
Yeah.
I guess. To get the pussy, you know what I'm saying? So whether that is nice date, whether that is, hey, can you shoot me some lunch money? Or I think I'd just rather skip over all of that and just get straight to the, like, because with a female, they know if they want to fuck you from jump.
Yeah.
But like you said,
you could talk yourself out of it, though, quick.
You can't.
Of getting fucked
some female,
right in that
are you,
moment.
And that, see, that's what it is, though. I know I want to fuck you, but are you worthy of me giving you some pussy? So now I gotta come and I gotta give and I gotta, you know, make shit look nice. I ain't even really that type of nigga. I'd rather just come to you like, well, shit, what you want? What
the
cash?
Pussy
what's your
worthy
cash
enough
at?
To be tricking,
you know,
off on?
Like, You say what, bro?
Is the pussy worthy enough to pay for it?
For
sure.
And that's the thing about paying like out in general.
How do you know, though? How would you know if you get it?
Even with the dates and the gas money and the and I, now I got the pussy and I did 17 things versus me just hitting you over the head one time.
It's like trying a new restaurant, bro. You could go off the reviews, but you never know until you eat the food.
Everything is a risk. You know what I'm saying? So, unfortunately, you know, you just got to pay for some risk.
I ain't going to lie. I personally feel like this, though. I feel like if you genuinely like a chick, and you taking that out because you like her.
For sure.
That's not paying for the pussy because you actually paying for the good time. You actually paying for. But if your intentions is only to smash and you take on a date, you pay for the pussy. Your intentions only to smash and you bought her this, you bought her that, you pay for the pussy. You bought
it. And now see, in that case, I feel like a lot of guys, like a lot of y'all feel like y'all can't do that. But in all actuality, like when you meet somebody and you know, like I'm just on some fuck shit. Like I'm trying to fuck. That's it. That's all. Like, you can literally tell a woman that, like, in that very moment, it's up to her to, you know what I'm saying, to continue to fuck with you or expect you to be doing all this extra shit. But at least, like, you said, like, Shirley, I ain't trying to date. I don't want to go on dates. I just want to fuck. I want to link and fuck when I want to fuck. And that's that.
By that bottle.
Facts. Facts. Yeah. I don't know, man. I don't think so. I paid for some pussy once. I'm going to tell y'all a story, though. So I was in Miami, right? I'm 18. So my this was Miami Memorial Day weekend back when it was really bussing though.
Yeah.
Like Memorial Day weekend don't even happen in Miami like it used to. It used to be like hip hop weekend where this was the year they shot I'm on one video down there with like Ross, Drake.
Okay.
And and like they all bought out KOD. Every night, you feel me? Like it was a lot of shit going on out there.
Some pussy that weekend.
Yeah, so like me and my guys down there, we 18 though, so we like the youngest people down there. Like nobody else down our age, so we shorties and shit. You know, so we green though. We don't know what the fuck going on. So we get the Ciroc bottle, bitch. You know, Diddy was promoting hard with the Ciroc. He got the bitches walking the middle of the street with the. I said I'm gonna stop saying bitch on the show. so he got the chicks walking down the street. With the bottles and shit, the cardboard bottles. So we get some of them to the room, and they like, yeah, it's like they tell us kind of up front, like, yeah, y'all don't trying to fuck. It's like 150, and I'm like, damn, bitch, we thought y'all liked us. Like, I ain't like get the fuck on then. So we get their ass out of there, and a couple like we was down there for like 3-4 days. So like maybe the third or fourth day, I meet this chick from Detroit. Now she a regular chick. She ain't no Ciroc model, none of that. So I'm thinking we smooth. Like she like 25, I'm 18. It was like, bitch, you know I'm, I look like I'm 18. I look like I'm probably 15, bitch. Like, you know what I'm saying? So we kicking it or whatever. It was too and she was nice. She was probably somebody's wife back in Detroit. You feel me? Yeah. But we get them to the crib and it's the fucked up part. So we stand at the Royal Palm Hotel on 15th and Collins and shit. So we get them to the room. We'll get them on the elevator. So we hop on the elevator. It's a white man already on the elevator when the doors open. But he don't get off. He stay on with us. You know what I'm saying? It's like the elevator hit the first floor. This nigga stay on the elevator. We get on. And we was standing on floor 12. So we hit the button for 12. He get off before us. So when we get to the floor, the thing about the Royal Palm at the time is that you know how like room numbers in a hotel, if you stay on the 9th floor, the room number is going to be 9-10, 9-11, 9-12. If you on the 7th floor, it's going to be 7-10, so on. So at the Royal Palm, it wasn't like that. All the room on every floor was just 10, 11, 12. So you had to know what floor you was on. So we get off thinking we got off on 12. So we trying to key card to the door. Shit not working. We had room 9 and 12. Trying to key card to the door. The shit not working. Try the other key card. The shit not working. We not knowing we on the wrong floor. You feel me? Because the white man must have pressed a button to where he got off, but he had another button pressed. So we thinking since the elevator door open again, it must be our shit. You feel me? Yeah. So we tweaking the shit with the door. So we like, fuck it. We can't get in the room. Let's fuck the bitch. Fuck these hoes on the stairs. So we go we go on the stairs, bro. But like my homie, for whatever reason, I don't know if he just didn't want to fuck her on the stairs. You know, I don't know what he was on, but he wasn't trying to fuck the other chick no more. So the other chick just pull out a phone and record me fucking shorty, though. You feel me? So shorty, like, pull the rub out, put it in her mouth, put the rub on and all that. I'm like, I ain't never had a bitch do that before. Like, you know what I'm saying? So,
prostitution.
Like, this
bitch
is up professional.
They did this
I'm
before,
like,
yeah,
this bitch is up professional.
These still the same girls that said that with 150, right?
Nah, them was the Ciroc chicks. Now, they said 150 when it was over. I was going to get to that. Like, yeah, so after all the shit was over, she like, yeah, it's 150. I'm like, bitch, what? You should have said that before. Like,
so you got finessed into paying for some pussy.
But you know what it made me wonder, though? I was like, damn, did all y'all bitches, like, send out a group text to say it was 150? Like, how y'all all saying the same price? Y'all all from different cities. Like, why is the pussy...
It's not a lot. Like, from every city, though. I was in Atlanta. Yeah. Me and my cousin was in Atlanta. So I didn't pay for the pussy. Normally, right. I paid for the pussy.
Right.
So you got finessed out. You know, if you was in Atlanta, you definitely got scammed.
My cousin, and we wasn't even in, so we was in Georgia, all
right? Right.
We was in, like, Savannah, you know what I'm saying? Before we went to the A. So them bitches, them ladies out there is different. You feel me? They get right to the point. So I went out there. It was, like, around the 4th of July. It was, like, 3 years ago. So the 4th, it was lit. We was finna go to, what's that shit with the roller coasters?
Six Flags.
Yeah, I don't ever remember that name, but we met them at Six Flags, and they was older at the time. I was short. I wasn't even an adult yet. You feel me?
Yeah.
So I'm like, we got some grown women. You feel me?
Right.
And my cousin, like, yeah. I told them to meet us here. So when he showing me the messages, the message is green, but all her pictures she on the iPhone. I'm like, how she text you and her message popping up green? Like, you feel me? She was texting off an app.
Right.
I'm like, that was my first red flag. I'm like, oh, that's something wrong with this situation.
Right.
Why she text you off an app? She got a boyfriend or something. He making it seem like he met these females at a party or something, and they just got up with him. So he went to his crib. He like, which one you want? I'm like, you don't talk to none of them, you feel me? He like, nah, which one you want? I'm like, I want her, the little chocolate one.
Right.
So after we, you feel me, it got wild. You feel me? It was a fun night for me.
Right.
I was in there like, I'm lit. You feel me? So he come back out. He like, yeah, you got $100 on you, though? I'm like, $100 for what? Yeah, I got 50. I just need 100.
Right.
I say, what you need $100 for? Like, where we going?
Right.
We ain't drinking or nothing. It's 3 o'clock in the morning now. You feel me? He like, that's how much they want. I'm like, what? That's how much they want? Want for what? They want 150. I already gave Shorty $100. I got $50 more. You need $100.
So they was really going for $75 each.
Really? Basically.
I'm falling. Island. I'm like, that's like the cheap pussy.
He like, you man, we do this shit all the time. You scared? I'm like, scared of what?
Right.
I just felt a little finesse. That's all.
Yeah, facts though.
Like, bitch, why you ain't say that? But fuck,
I finessed a little bitch in Vegas. I finessed a little bitch in Vegas, but I was actually looking to pay for some pussy in Vegas. You know what I'm saying? Even though I was kind of blue, I did. Because I end up bumping into some bitches the next day, and me and folks and them actually end up getting free pussy. You know? And it really wasn't even free, because it was Vegas, so we had a ball. But the first shorty, I met on the strip, and she told us, like, the first night we got there, like, yeah, we here for a good time, not a long time, blah, blah, blah. So in my mind, I'm registering shit already, trying to figure out what that means.
Right,
so, you know, we get the numbers, we exchange numbers and shit. She tell me, like, yeah, I'm out here trying to make some money, blah, 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 blah. And I'm saying, oh, cool. I'm all for the support. I'm in Vegas, though. I'm trying to live it up. Shit, we out here kicking it. I'm trying to support the cause. So she tell me 150. I don't know what the fuck it is about the 150 number.
It's the one.
When she get to the room, you know, we woo, woo, woo. And I'm like, damn, all I got is 100. You're not going to take this 100. You're going to tweak with me. And you know what I'm saying? And I damn near woof-wop your ass and get you out the room. Like, what you going to do? She took the 100 and she was kind of salty about it. But shit, I'm like, you shouldn't be selling pussy no way.
It's that extra 50 that they need.
Yeah,
like,
what's the extra 50, though? You know what I'm saying? That's they cut. They get 100 to somebody else.
So they
got
to get to whoever. If they
but this Vegas though, right. You shouldn't be selling
Vegas.
But
Vegas got all the pimps in Vegas. Like, it's legal to pimp hoes out there.
The thing about Vegas is they be real prostitutes. Like in Miami, these be regular bitches that's coming to Miami to sell a little pussy real quick. I could never fuck a real prostitute. Like, this is really your job.
Is it really a difference though?
It's like you never know.
But listen though, it's like you never know. I want to play the devil's advocate. You know, baddies don't get mad at me. But it's some baddies that literally travel, like the baddies of the baddies that literally travel just to, like, low key sell pussy.
Finesse,
like,
niggas from city to city.
You feel me? Like, all that flued out shit, like, that's like, how far away from that is prostitution? You know what I'm saying? Like, I got a couple associates.
But I think the difference is this, though.
This nigga flying me out. This nigga.
I think the difference is this.
You fucking all these niggas at this point.
Them hoes picking and choosing, though. Like, a prostitute gonna take that bread from whatever nigga come with
for
that
whatever
bread,
nigga.
Though. And I think that's the difference for me. That's like, I can't fuck a real prostitute. I feel like, even if this bitch is trying to get some bread, this bitch kind of like me, because she could pick whatever nigga that she want to get this bread from. But this bitch, she trying to get some bread, but she kind of like, I don't know. A prostitute just like that. So it's just too different,
much.
Bro.
It's too much. No.
So you, I had to kick some prostitutes out in Vegas before. It was some white bitches too. I was scared. I thought they was going. They was like, we gonna call the police. You gonna pay up? We bitch. Y'all gotta go. Like
they gonna call the police. They gonna go to jail.
Like, well, what about porn stars? Because they technically get paid to have sex too.
You said they prostitutes?
Porn stars.
Or would I fuck
get
one?
Yeah, they get paid to have sex too.
I would fuck a prostitute. I mean, I would fuck a porn star. Yeah.
I pay for that experience. I'm thinking
about right now. Yeah.
I pay for that experience too. Yeah. But they gotta be the person I want though.
Yeah. A normal nigga can't just pay a prostitute. We gotta talk to Mike, buddy.
A normal person can't just pay a prostitute to fuck all the time. Like, them bitches only really be wanting to fuck with other niggas who do that shit, like, in that industry. All of them clean, they got their papers. So.
Right.
Yeah, ain't no emailing shorty like, let me see what's to that. Nah.
Yeah, I just found out a lot of prostitutes be married. That shit tweaked me out.
Oh, and the husbands be the pimps.
Damn. Yeah, I can't imagine.
Well,
can't.
There one,
my,
right
my
there.
Favorite,
they
my favorite. I mean, not did I say favorite? My prostitutes be married. I meant porn stars be married. But my favorite porn star pregnant right now. Ooh. She engaged, bro. Sarah Banks, bro.
Yeah,
that bitch pregnant. Oh, everybody know who she is today. Yeah,
I didn't even know.
Niggas saw out. Yeah, I followed the bitch on Twitter.
Damn, Miss Banks.
The whole room just went, what?
Shit. Yeah,
shame bro. On you.
I think it's a white dude, too,
I'm
going to
pull a compilation up later.
Did she get pregnant doing the porno, or did she get pregnant?
No, I think it's a regular dude, G.
Tell me, she love this nigga, type.
I don't know. I think
she
it's a regular
he
dude.
Love her.
Yeah, he love her, G.
I know he met that her, like, crazy. I seen you, but...
That shit, you know what's crazy? All right, I got a funny story.
She said she gonna get back to it when she popped the baby out, though. She said that on Twitter. She said she gonna get back in the game. Yeah.
She said she back out here, huh?
Yeah.
Like, what you gonna tell... Yeah, when I used to... Before I had you, I was fucking...
You gotta be 100, because somebody in third grade gonna pull that shit up.
On my mama.
Somebody in
they
third
pull
grade.
That picture
kids
up.
Ruthless,
show and
G.
Tell.
Man.
Kids be bogus. Kids be ruthless.
I mean, though. At the point that she decided to even have a child, it was just like over with. It don't matter if it's a boy or a girl, because a girl, like, ooh, the girl, they gonna just, you know, automatically. Yeah. I'm a porn star, so I know you freaky, like, type
shit. Like, what if my daughter
grew up and wanted
to
do that
too?
That's what I'm saying. But you know what's crazy? Most women who are like that, they don't have a problem with it because they've experienced it. Like, I interviewed this one artist, and I ain't gonna say her name, but, like, you know, I was just asking her, like, the type of music you making with you having a daughter, like you don't feel no type of way. Like, what if your daughter think, like, you know, want to grow up, like, you got your ass done. What if your daughter just coming out, like, okay, mom, I want an ass too. Like, that shit don't affect them. Like,
Hey, shout out to you for asking that question, because most motherfuckers wouldn't have never asked that question. So shout out to you for being real and asking some real shit, because a lot of people in them interviews be
they be hyping that shit up. But like, personally, for real, I just be like, that shit is crazy. Like, this, the world is really coming to a social media as like internet as world, and like youth look up to this shit. Feel me? And I just personally don't think all that shit okay. Like,
they talking about
me,
that.
Let them still see the natural shit too. You know what I'm saying? Like, no shade to, you know, anybody that's out there doing this shit. But like, it's conversations that need to be had for sure.
Cause in the summertime, I didn't see no kids at the park.
Right.
Like, yeah, it's on Instagram.
I seen them on TikTok.
Like,
right now though, like, I'm a teacher and shit, right? So like, we do like basketball, like. When I was a shorty, if it was 12 boys in 8th grade, 10 of their ass was trying out for the basketball team. Like, now we can't put a team together. Like, it's only 8 boys that said they want to play. Only 4 of them show up. And only one of them really know how to play. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, them niggas, like, I'm like, why you ain't come to practice? I'm like, keep it. Why you really ain't come to practice? Like, man, I need to play that game, though. I had to sign in to get my little registry for Call of Duty or whatever the fuck. I guess they got to sign in.
He know how to play 2K like a motherfucker, though. All
right.
You don't know how to hoop for
that's
real.
That's because they
kids
be
in the crib, bro.
Motherfuckers for that shit. Now, these kids trying to get famous off
But you know what? The game industry is wide open, so I'm all for it. The only issue I have is that they lose sight of the real world. Mm-hmm. Like, when I was teaching in the high schools, like, most of my students didn't even have hobbies. Like, they like, I like hanging out with my friends, being on Instagram, talking to my friends on the phone. Like, girl, what are we talking about? Like, we used to shoot, like, we used to, you know what I'm saying?
I used to love to
jump double dutch, go outside. Yeah. Like, what? Like,
they kick it. They don't even go like we used to go to each other's house to play the game. Now they be at their own crib, logging in, talking to each other,
playing the game.
They don't even be around each other no more. Like,
so Chocolate Battery, I got a question for you. Since we on the topic of what we talking about, is there like when you fucking with a nigga? Like I said, even if you want to, you know, you find him attractive and you think you might want to give him some pussy. Mm-hmm. Is there like qualifications or what do you expect the nigga to do to lead up as far as like getting a pussy? You know what I'm saying? Since we all said that motherfucker had paid for some pussy before, not technically whether they did it like cash up front or through buying shit or paying for shit. You know what I'm saying? Like
anybody trying to hit Chocolate Baddie, pay attention
qualifies,
to
what qualifies a nigga? All like, what,
take
what's
notes.
The limit or what's the over limit or like what type of, what's the word I'm looking for?
What's the requirement?
What's the requirements of what he got to do?
You got to get in the coochie. Give us the
A through Z, though.
Yeah, because I know it ain't just looking good. It's just you being attracted to him and you think you want to give him some pussy. It comes with some extra shit and some extra effort. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
For sure. For me, personally, I'm a vibe person.
For sure.
So I want to vibe with you first because for me, sex is spiritual. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm at an age where I ain't just like, you know, trying to be fucking any and everybody.
So you say some vibe, like a picnic.
You know, I'm trying
type,
to vibe with you. I'm
poetry,
trying to feel
slam
you out.
Type, you know, picnic.
I mean, it
beach.
Ain't even gotta be like no shit like that. Like I'm a fun person, so we could do whatever. Like,
okay,
it's
anything,
limitless,
okay,
but
sure.
As long as you got a good vibe and you know, if I like you, I like you. Never know. Ain't no, I don't put time stamps on when I'm gonna get a pussy.
For sure. So you say the vibe could be like today, though. Tonight, then you might get the pussy up tonight is what I'm saying. Not to me, but I'm saying. If you,
hey, I feel like Chocolate Baddie, like, you know what I got from that too, though? Like, that she's a genuine person and she only fucking with raw meat, though, because you ain't having no spiritual sex.
I know a
no
porn star ain't Chocolate Baddie, too.
They don't even sound like no condom involved,
really
kind of
like childish in general.
That
though,
condom
like,
shit is kind of like, because if you, why you don't trust a nigga, why you fucking niggas you don't trust? Like, take.
Niggas not like, fucking. Niggas not fucking females facts. With condoms that they feel like they should. If I feel like I shouldn't be having sex with you,
I'm not going to
have sex with you.
Right.
If I feel
right.
like I'm finna fuck you, then I'm not wearing a condom because I feel like I fake weight trust you a little bit, not
bro.
To harm
that's
me. You
feel like
me?
That's
no?
the first level of trust.
Yeah.
That's the first level
yeah,
of trust.
Get rid of them condoms, bro.
Time out.
It's only for people 30
if
plus.
If I feel like I
got to
put a
know?
Condom on with you, I'm not fucking you. Like, if I feel, if you give me condom vibes, like, this bitch dirty.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not fucking with you.
I agree
like,
with
you know
that.
What I'm saying? I be having, like, that's why I don't fuck just any and everybody. Everybody I never fucked was like, damn, she giving me no condom vibes. I can raw dig this, you feel me?
So wait, what is no condom vibes? Like, what that look like? Like, how
see,
do you develop
you
that trust?
Like.
Yeah, how do you develop
like.
That trust?
It's just, I don't know. I just, you, and before, and that's why it's good to, and that's why it's good to, that's why it is good to not fuck on the first night and maybe kick it or chill with a chick
exactly.
more than once or twice because you might it's some real examining you gotta do. It's some
right.
real, you know what I'm saying?
If
I gotta come to your crib. I then gotta hit your medicine cabinets. I then gotta see what type of soap you use. I then gotta see what you smell like when you laid up next to me. Like it just be certain shit that just be making you feel like I could raw slaw her. You know what I'm saying? And just okay. on some grown individual shit, I feel like as a grown individual, if you got some where you, I feel like that's something you should let be known. You feel me? But a lot of people facts. Won't, though. So facts. That's why it's really kind of like a trust thing. Like, I feel like I trust her enough where I can raw dog her. You know what I'm saying?
If I'm paying $150, I'm wearing a condom. I ain't going to lie to you.
If I'm paying $150 for some pussy, I'm wearing a condom.
If you
yeah.
pay
if
anything,
I'm buying,
anything,
if I'm buying pussy, cash up for
That's yeah. condom wear.
Mm. If I'm out of town, period, bro.
Out of town,
because I'm
yeah.
only buying pussy. I would never in my life buy pussy in Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
I'm only buying pussy out of town. If I'm out of town, I don't
so
care.
So why you
what
gonna, why you gonna leave the Chicago bags them, out? You
need, no, that shit
this the crib.
I'm not paying for
like,
no Chicago pussy.
You better run
home.
That. This the crib.
I can't do this
I got home court advantage. You better exactly. give me that pussy you tweaking.
And just remember, fellas, they make female condoms, too. Fuck you, time out.
Fact.
So we shouldn't be the only ones strapping because they make female
they
condoms
do.
As well.
Hey, you know,
but they will. We won't know about that because they ain't going to buy that shit. You feel me? It's up.
That's the fact. I ain't buying no female condoms.
It's to us to buy the condoms and wear the condoms.
Facts. Hey, what y'all feel about the chicks that be like on Facebook and shit and on Instagram and shit? Like, if a nigga ain't paying my bills, nigga, I'm a grown ass woman. If a nigga not doing this, doing that, doing this. And you want some pussy, I want this pay. I feel like bitch just sell a pussy then.
I just had a conversation with my mama about this the other day. My birthday Wednesday, right?
Right.
So we was talking about my birthday and shit, and she just like, yeah, if this nigga don't, basically saying something like, if the nigga that she dealing with, my mama dealing with right now, and I understand what she mean in a way, but I disagreed in a way, because she said, if he ain't meeting the standards, well, her bills need to be paid, and he got to go type shit. And I'm right. So every, you feel, so you, if you single right now, you got to pay this shit on your own, right? I see if a motherfucker meet you halfway.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I feel like if a nigga just full blown, all right, all these bills paid, baby, I'm gonna take care of your light bill, your everything, make sure your kids' phone bills pay. That shit's stupid to me, like.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? And then y'all ain't even probably gonna be together for the rest of y'all life.
Right.
So why pay?
That's that old school shit. But I feel like if you in a relationship on GP, like, well, I'm not gonna say that. I feel like to each his own. You know what I'm saying? I feel like everybody needs to communicate with each other about what they want in relationships, because that's how shit be going left. Like, you know, women be feeling like, oh, I want you to do this and that and the third. And then a man might feel like, well, I'm taking care of you, bitch, and you want to go to work, and I really want you to stay here and do this. You know what I'm saying? That's a conversation that a lot of people just don't have up front. Like, I think now that times have changed, you know, obviously it's not the traditional way where, like, the man is taking all, you know, all the responsibilities. So now we having these conversations where it's like, okay, you want to go 50, you want to go half and half with me, and you got certain people still stuck in the traditional, like, no, I'm not, you know, like, certain women still just like, I ain't with that shit.
It was only traditional because y'all couldn't really work. Y'all couldn't get out and do shit.
Right, because they didn't have jobs.
A lot of y'all got, like, better careers than we doing shit. You know what I'm saying? Y'all, for the most part, kind of like, y'all, they didn't even know kind of like. I know more bread when it's on the female side than I know niggas. You know what I'm saying? Right. And times have changed. You know what I'm saying? Shit has evolved. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, it was traditional because that was just how shit was. It wasn't no other option. Wasn't no other choice. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But now, it's shit didn't change.
Shit definitely has changed.
And there was a lot that came with that, too, because, for one, you know, women couldn't work. Yeah. They couldn't do X, Y, Z. So, niggas had to provide. They didn't have a choice whether they want to or not. Then, secondly, like, When you was doing that, it wasn't no question whether a girl's gonna cook, clean, wash the clothes, take care of the kids. It wasn't no question. Like,
right.
It wasn't none of that. And you go back to biblical times, she had to be a virgin. Like, she couldn't even fuck before to get
y'all
married.
Y'all too silly.
A lot of that traditional shit. Hey, that shit. A lot of that traditional shit out the window.
That's why I'm saying it's time to have these conversations, like, with your partners and stuff. Like, whoever you dealing with, like, y'all need to know, like, what type of relationship you want to be in. Like, if you know you ain't the type of nigga that don't want to be paying all the bills, you speak up now. Don't even make me believe that that's what you want to do for the rest of your life. Because I'm going to be mad if you switch up later on down the line.
Ultimately, though, I feel like if every man had the means to pay for everything, I think a nigga would. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think if a nigga had the means or had the right income to support everything, I think a nigga would.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, I know some niggas who got it. Bro.
I know some niggas who work in IT, they got it, making six figures.
They like, bitch, got me fucked up. She's not gonna pay everything.
If I made six figures and I like you, and then don't let me, like, put a baby in you, I wouldn't mind you staying at the crib. But with staying at the crib, I'm a simple nigga. It's simple shit that need to be done. I need meal. I need back rub.
I need
dicks up. And that's every night.
Whenever,
I'm taking care of you every day. I'm asking for the simple shit.
You can't
every
have
day.
Your hair not done.
Ain't no way around.
You gotta have your feet done.
Oh, you going too far.
I'm not gonna lie.
You gotta look like
bro.
A different
you
bitch
ever
every
come
day.
In this house without your hair cut. Nigga, you better
I'm
have.
Paying
you better
bills,
be at,
though.
As I'm going to the nail shop, you better be going to the nail shop.
You'll be surprised how many niggas out here taking care of females.
I'm paying bills for you.
And niggas still can't get what they want when they come to the crib.
That's sucker shit.
Yeah, nah, that's real too. That's
listen
real
too. Though,
ain't
for
no
me,
feel like fucking if them bills paid.
I personally, like, I'm paying the bills though. Like, if I'm with a chick, but my thing is, like, I already got my situation set up, so it's like you gonna move in with me anyway. So it's like my bills are already my bills. Like, they ain't gonna, my bills didn't go up because your
ain't
ass
gotta change
moved in.
Shit, right?
You
right,
feel
right,
me?
Right,
like,
right.
So I'm gonna just pay what I've been paying. You can move in. You feel me? And like, I just feel like I wouldn't want to put myself in a position. It's just like, all right, I get with shorty. We move into a new crib together. And then we paying 50-50. If we get into it, one of us gotta go, and it's like a toss up. Like,
see,
I might
I'm
gotta
saying?
I'm out moving cause I broke up with my bitch. You gotta go, shorty. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's over with.
See, that's
I gotta stop
keep
saying
so.
Bitch on the show, man. That's my new year.
But no, to answer your question earlier, I do not believe, like, you know, how I'm not one of those type of women where I'm like, oh, he got to do this. He got to pay my bills. I'm not a pay my bills type of bitch. But I do believe, like, if I'm fucking with you and I need help and you, like, you know, just blankly just don't want to help me for whatever the fuck reason, that's going to make me not fuck with you. Like, damn, G, like, fuck. If you ask me for some shit, especially because I'm the type of person, I don't like asking nobody for shit. Like, even if I need it, like, I will not ask.
So do you ask for shit after you've given the pussy up? Or beforehand?
I asked before.
Cause
I play mind game. I ain't gonna lie. That's probably my toxic trait. I play mind game.
Red flag.
Cause I wanna see, like, I wanna know, like, if I was to ask, like, when I do ask niggas for shit, it really to be, like, it really be to see what they gonna
say.
Yeah, I'm like, let me see what his reaction is. Let me see how much you really fuck with. Like,
sure. Okay.
But, yeah.
Nah, but the actual question was not, are you that type of chick? You feel like those type of chicks should just sell the pussy up front instead of being like, oh, if you with me, you gotta pay this, you gotta pay that. Like, it sounds like you wanna sell the pussy.
I mean, that's what it sounds like. I've ran into chicks that it felt like, damn, bitch, you might as well ask me to pay for the pussy. You know what I'm saying? Like, I've ran into chicks that I be feeling like you run into a chick, y'all talking 2-3 days, and all of a sudden she telling you all her problems and the lights finna get. Bitch, you might as well have just sold me some pussy. How much is the light bill, baby? How much is the light bill?
I ain't never paid a bill for a shorty.
The reason why it's no to your question is because OnlyFans. OnlyFans to me prove that bitches who think that they want to sell the pussy, they not really about that shit for real. Because when it come down to it,
you gotta get a little closer to the mic, bro. I can barely hear.
My fault. OnlyFans to me prove that bitches not down to get a pussy up for real. Because when it come down to it, the things that niggas gonna wanna request from you, and then, like, I look at it like a show. You only as good as your last performance. So it ain't about getting me to subscribe, it's about keeping me subscribed. You know what I'm saying? It's a whole, so, like, yeah, if you coming off I need you to pay my bills, ooh, or you should just sell the pussy. A lot of bitches ain't cut for that. That lifestyle. They might think so, and they go and they try it, and then they realize that, you feel me,
when they realize I should go 50-50 with that nigga on them bills. I ain't been like that. Yeah,
not 50-50, but I would say that's kind of like, it's kind of like they is selling a pussy without saying they selling a pussy. Because if you, like first off, females know we trying to, like, we know y'all trying to fuck. Feel me? So if a female just instantly start, oh, like, my lights got cut off, this, that, and third, like, in other words, she's asking you to, you feel me, cover that light bill, and she might, you know, look a little on my face.
On what my man said, as far as what he was saying about the OnlyFans, I had an ex who was, you know, she was always, she, and one thing I can say about it is, she is a chick that, even if she not working, she gonna find a way to make money, as far as, like, whether she gonna start selling clothes, or whether she gonna start. So, at a point in time, she made OnlyFans, and I told her, like, you know, how much you making off that shit, you know what I'm saying? Peanuts. And I told her, like, maybe you need to spruce things up. You know what I'm saying? And this me talking to her as a friend.
Let me hold the camera. Shit, I get you right.
Yeah, this ain't me talking to her as a ex nigga that we cool and friends. Now this me talking to her as, like, I'm trying to, shit, you need to start fucking on OnlyFans. You need to, damn near, if you want to get your money up on that bitch, you need to take it to that next level.
Right.
Hey, I'ma say this. Shorty don't do OnlyFans no more. Hey, she wasn't built for that shit. She was on that little cute little nipple titty videos, but she knew deep down inside, she got a daughter. She just knew, like, it wasn't, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't for her. You know what I'm saying? She knew.
A lot of chicks with tattoos be on that though. Like, they don't want to get hit. They feel like motherfucker gonna recognize them. Even if they take their face
she
out.
She got to get the tattoos,
like,
too.
On the OnlyFans thing, you could still, like, screenshot that shit, screen record that shit, and still see the people.
And it's still out here.
And I be seeing people. The OnlyFans is not only for, like sex shit. I see people. I got an OnlyFans player. Basketball players got that shit. And they
And that's what people confused OnlyFans.
Yeah, they think OnlyFans, like,
it was so much freaky shit going on. You forgot that OnlyFans was, nigga, I could be a water expert, and I could be showing different waters
leaking
every week
your,
on that bitch.
New music,
telling you what's the
Young
best
boy
pH balance.
Posts a lot of music that he never dropped on OnlyFans.
Yeah.
Next thing you know, I see a girl, her ass out, like, subscribe to OnlyFans. Then they want us to pay $20 for that shit. I'm not about to pay $20 for
porn
that shit.
Pornhub. Frisky.
When it's real porn out here.
I can go on Pornhub.
And them professionals.
I think it just be the fantasization, the fantasizing
of the person.
You knowing this
person.
Like, you know this person. You been in her inbox. She ain't been going.
Yeah.
Now you done paid $8.99 for her
little
weak-ass
ain't paying for a bitch I know.
Yeah.
No, sir.
Yeah. And it's crazy. I support it. the ex chick just because I know her situation. So I paid for it for a month, but yeah. I didn't crack you in real life and really got nasty with you. Bro. You know what I'm saying? So it was only gonna happen. I was only gonna pay for that shit for so long. Where I would be like, look, right. We need to start fucking on camera. Then we need to get we gonna get paid off.
Give
this
me
shit.
My right. cut.
Let's, yeah,
so
we
listen,
need to get paid off this
have
shit.
Have y'all ever? Have y'all ever like did that? Like, have y'all ever had sex with a girl for their OnlyFans page?
Never. Yeah. I haven't.
Nah. No. I have not.
Y'all, funny story. Story time.
I hope I ain't know nobody.
So why? Okay.
Tell us about
I
your
moved
OnlyFans.
To the A.
Chocolate baddie.
And I met this dude. So he, you know, we went out on a date, right? Y'all found out this nigga is an OnlyFans. Like,
nigga?
He do OnlyFans. Yes. So I'm like, what you do? He be, nah, I be fucking. if the red flag emoji was out, was a thing, then I'm the fuck. That shit was just so different for me. Like,
and that, you said, like, that was like what he do, or that's just some shit he was doing?
No,
like, that's what he do.
That's his job. Like,
right.
Like,
that's paying
off
bills.
He was trying to get this shit. I didn't feel like I done wasted my time. Like, y'all do media. He like, oh, that's what's up. Ooh, ooh. I'm like, yeah, what do you do? He like, I'm an OnlyFans.
I'm in media too.
He said, we should work together.
I'm in media too.
OnlyFans.
He tried to put you in
the
mix.
I'm like, I hope you ain't trying to scout me because that ain't me. You feel me?
Y'all went out to dinner.
Actually, we went to like this little waterfall. It was actually one of my favorite dates. Like, we went to this little waterfall.
Damn.
It was
vibe.
Decent.
He was
like,
trying to vibe his way into you
and
OnlyFans.
He was trying
fans.
To vibe yeah. his way on his OnlyFans. I
he
promise you, I blocked him
youth.
After that date. I blocked him after that date. But that shit was different. Like, I'm like, damn, now I see how niggas will feel, you know,
so
like trying to date a porn star or some shit like that.
Niggas do the same thing women do, basically. We sell our shit to it.
Basically.
Facts.
I say this nigga
just not as well as y'all.
Just not as. I mean,
it ain't too many buyers for us. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
the market really ain't too high.
It it's definitely like, is.
It's not.
You know,
I ain't gonna lie. That's a lot of buyers,
no,
though.
It
it's
definitely
a lot of scouts.
It's
a lot of scouts. Yeah. I feel like it's like the age requirements, though. Like, once you hit like 30 something, it's over with. You can't even.
It's
I'm
y'all. I ain't gonna lie. It's the appearance. It's the appearance for men. You gotta have yo.
No cap. My vet, though, I had a vet. Like, you was talking about a 40-year-old. Like, I done had 45. I done
yeah.
had a 50-year-old.
Yeah, me
before.
Too. That shit ain't all that, man.
Check me out. My 45, my 45-year-old was cold. It had a bag. And was. And I don't even want to say she was paying for dick, but she had it. So
yeah.
she would pay for whatever as long as I played my role right. And with that role came time, conversation, and dick.
Exactly.
And
a lot of dick.
Fumbled it.
A lot of
you
dick.
You know what I'm saying? But it was a great time, though. You know what I'm saying?
That's,
it was a great time.
That's all I... When I was younger...
But I wouldn't necessarily say she was paying for it. She just was...
She fucked with
she you. She mother, bro. You know, she
yeah.
got kids down at my age. You
oh,
feel me? She,
yeah.
she That's all she knows to take care of a young nigga like me. You feel me?
Yeah, for sure. I love older women. But them older women be like... needy as hell. Like...
Low-key missing.
They sometimes right. don't understand. When I was like 18, I was messing with this 38-year-old. And I moved to her house. I left my mama's house. My mama was like, what the fuck? You feel me? She never.
You were strong at 18.
I moved in her house with her.
I wouldn't
big ass crib. She got like 3 kids. They all, one of them went to school with me. You feel me?
Whoa.
So,
yeah, that's
whoa. Yeah, I guess dirty.
Damn.
Yeah, I guess
you
grunt.
Super strong.
So how close was y'all in age?
So when I was 18. When I was 18, he was 19.
Super
so sick. he was in the same grade as me, bro. And we was cool
was
too.
You nailing this
we
OG.
We was cool. And I'm finna be honest. He fell out with me over that shit. Like
fell out.
Fell out. He ain't wanna fuck. Cause his like
one of us probably wouldn't be here right now.
Wait. So y'all was cool. And right, then
finna,
you started smashing his OG.
I've knew him since.
Damn.
I knew him since a shorty. And I now we
ooh,
on this.
Wow. Yeah.
I ain't gonna
yeah.
lie to y'all. This shit.
Y'all better keep y'all OGs away.
Watch, bro, man.
I felt a little bad. Yeah, had y'all mama. I love OGs.
I love OGs too, but not the guys. OGs,
I love
your mama.
I love
that's
women.
Different.
I love older women since I was a shorty. Like since I was the first time I could get in something, I got in something grown. You feel me? So all I wanted from that point on was older women. I didn't like females my age. Like I didn't get. I mean, I probably talked to a few of them because it was easy. You feel me? But I never took no little ass girl serious. You feel me? So when I met her, we was like. 14, 15. It was so weird though how it happened. Cause I went to their house one day. It was a football game. The Bears lost. And she just out of the blue just kept, she was like throwing shots at me, like calling me her on some jokingly shit in front of people.
Them porn titles.
But she was calling me her boyfriend, her little boyfriend. She, you on that when you 18, call me type shit.
And mom, when I fuck turned 18, son's best friend. Right.
She was dead ass serious. I went to their crib. When I went to their crib, I never left after that. Like, we was in downstairs.
He had his Xbox in.
We was downstairs watching a movie and we had some little hoes with us, you feel me? And she was like, come here. When I came upstairs, I'm like, you feel me? What's going on? I'm not thinking too
much. Your homie was there?
My homie was there.
Oh, yeah, he was tripping. Because ain't no way my mama just telling you to come here.
And like, I was trying to keep it a secret. Like, don't tell him, you feel me? Because we cool. I don't know how a nigga going to take somebody he be with every day.
Every day? Cracking. Oh,
somebody wouldn't be here right now, B. Between me and you, a nigga wouldn't be on this
earth. If I could rewind town,
you wouldn't have did it?
I wouldn't have did it. You feel what I'm saying? Only off the strength because I am loyal to my, you feel me? But that was
grown. You talking that grown
coochie
cat?
That was grown coochie and she was that. Like, she ain't look like no average 38-year-old.
You say you backed on him over something that you felt was
worth it. I had to. We kind of cool now. Man,
that nigga never be for real cool with
you. I know in the back of his head, he... All
right, I ain't going to post this clip since y'all back cool, bro.
No, you can post it.
This might re-spark the shit.
Fuck that nigga. We be laughing at
the shit. You on here talking about
my... We be laughing at the shit now, like... When
I don't think that should have ever been funny, dude.
Yeah, I ain't going to laugh. My homie's cracked my mom.
I can hate my OG, but if I found out one of my homies fucking, I'm like, damn.
And he be with me every day, I'm going to feel some type of
way. Me and my mama can have a great relationship. I found out one of my homies fucking up, bro, I'm going to be mad.
I'm going to be mad at OG too, but it's good that you grew from that, bro. All jokes aside, it's good that you grew from that and you feel how you feel about it.
I still crack niggas' mamas, though.
For sure.
As you should,
King.
Just not the guy. Right. All right, but before we wrap up, though, I feel like chicks pay for dick, though, too, though, right?
Yeah.
Have you ever experienced a chick pay? I feel like if a nigga hitting a chick and staying in her crib for free,
she paying on my granddad. I've been
in
a couple cribs.
You right.
Especially if he ain't doing nothing while he's staying there.
Mama.
Yeah.
Just playing the game.
Doing nothing, playing the game. And hitting her.
I ain't never paid for no dick.
What else is she interested in? What else?
He ain't got no motivation, no dedication. He just in the crib playing the game and eating up the fruit snacks.
Yeah, I don't know if y'all watching Insecure. Issa was paying for it in the beginning,
you
season
who?
One. On Insecure, the little HBO show.
Oh, you talking about with the chocolate nigga?
Nah, Lawrence, the first nigga. She was paying for dick because Lawrence wasn't on shit at first. He was sitting on the couch chilling.
They wasn't even fucking barely.
It wasn't
type shit.
And the first season,
I feel like her situation was different because that was just a situation where they had been together their whole college life. Right. Feel me? And it was just to a point like, you know, like she just felt like stuck almost. Like how most women get, like, damn, I'm not happy. I don't know how to communicate that I'm not happy. This nigga just on his couch every fucking day. He ain't doing
so
shit.
I'm paying all
the bills. I'm tired. I love him though. You know, like that's one thing I can't say about East. Even looking at the seasons now, like she love that man. Like that ain't just paying for no dick. That's her man. That's her dick. Like she ain't paying for her dick.
Yeah.
Type shit.
Issa was holding them back though. Shout out to my nigga Lawrence because he bossed up when he got out that relationship.
Issa was holding them back.
Women be holding niggas back. It's just like Jeff Bezos. One day you hit Jeff Bezos in the news, like his wife finna divorce him. He finna lose half everything he got. 2 months later, Jeff Bezos finna be a trillionaire. That bitch is holding him back. He lost that relationship and went crazy.
That's motivation.
Dr. Dre next though. Watch Dr. Dre after this divorce, Dr. Dre finna be a trillionaire.
Different beats. He finna pass Kanye. It's finna be over with. It's different.
Issa was holding my boy back. Lawrence bossed up. Now he's straight. She got the new baby and shit. Shout out to Lawrence, man.
No comment.
A lot of bitches do be holding niggas back, and niggas be holding bitches back too. Females back too.
Yeah, relationships be tough when you chasing something. That's for sure, man. It should be a distraction half the time. But before we wrap up, man, gotta say happy birthday to Duck. I didn't even know that was birthday to Duck. Happy birthday to my brother. Yeah,
for sure. We ain't been asleep yet.
R.I.P. and all that. I started the show off with the slide instrumental. I ain't know if y'all gonna catch it.
Yeah, that's what you did. My birthday Wednesday too.
Fact.
So this whole month just finna be full of litness. You see, they got the bottles over there now, starting early.
Absolutely, man.
So yeah.
Shout out to y'all. My OG birthday next week.
Happy it's birthday.
Happy birthday, OG.
Happy birthday.
She dark skin.
Sagittarius season.
Oh, happy birthday to Cam, G.
Happy birthday, Cam.
Cam B-Day was yesterday, man. Shout out to Cam. Happy birthday.
Cam's corner right now.
Man, Cam couldn't be here, man. Remember we told we was playing with Cam, we were going to get a new Cam and have a new Cam's corner. And
yeah.
Shit. That shit would have been funny as hell. She would have been. Never forgave us for that shit.
Never forgave us for that shit, man.
But drop y'all handles again one more time so they let them know where to find y'all at.
First.
What's up? It's your favorite chocolate baddie, Mary J. Y'all could get up me at Chocolate Baddie Show on Instagram. Mary J on Instagram. I mean, not Instagram, on Facebook. On Instagram at boss.j. That's J with an H.
Everybody see me what they say. Flame, bitch, A. BCE Flame on everything. Anything you can look me up on, it's BCE Flame, BCI Flame. Two E's for sure. Make sure you put two E's in Flame, not BCE.
You gotta keep her around. She be looking out, G. I fuck with her. She be looking out.
My sister. If you don't put two E's in Flame, it's not, you're not really gonna find too much of me. So that's why it's so unique about that.
Right, facts. So
BCE Flame.
Gotta have the unique spelling these days, because everybody doing everything. Sure. It's oversaturated out here, man. I didn't give y'all the quote of the day, man. The quote of the day is good dope sell itself. You know what I'm saying? That quote came from The Wire. I forgot who said it. I want to rewatch the series to figure it out. But good dope sell itself. And the reason why I actually wrote that quote down was because I felt like in a media space, a lot of times, whether it be music or podcast or whatever it is, a lot of times people will be putting too much attention into the marketing side of shit and trying to sell shit and networking. And all that shit is important. But your content got to be good, though, too. Like,
for sure.
You know what I'm saying? You're going to get 10,000 people to come watch this shit, and it'll be mediocre, and they ain't going to never watch it again. Versus if you would have took your time, make sure your content was A1. You might have 100 people watching. Them 100 people going to go get them 10,000 because the word of mouth, because the content so good, people going to come running to it anyway. So, but it do relate to selling pussy, too. You out here struggling to sell some pussy. If that pussy was like that, you didn't even have to do that. It would be selling itself, man. For some sure. Nigga, how you cuffed up in a mansion somewhere and all that. So you might have to reevaluate your price, baby.
$150 is you need to deduct that if you're gonna do that. Stop charging. Why is y'all? Let me know why y'all charge us $150.
I think don't y'all need to charge more.
If you're gonna be charging more though, if you're gonna be trying to charge more than $150, $200, $300, you know, most of us be out here selling pussy for thousands. That shit need to come with
splash,
something just extravagant. I don't know what. But I feel like it just need to be something different that's happening.
Or
like
you shouldn't
be
paying for a pussy.
Just pay me for my dick.
Damn.
It shouldn't be regular sex for that much.
Yeah, it shouldn't be regular sex for that.
It got to be.
It
got to
be
something special.
Something like,
it definitely got to be something special for real.
It got to be something extravagant. Like, fuck me on a boat or something. On a yacht.
Facts. Hey, before. And we out.